Hey guys, it's Alex here. Today I'm going to be showing you how to host your own website on your Windows machine. This process that I'm going to show you is identical on Windows 7, Windows 8, and Windows 10. In this case, I'm going to be using Windows 10, and this is a very simple process that does not require downloading anything from any third-party websites. So the first thing you're going to need to do is simply go to Start and type in Features. And you need to enable the Internet services for this machine. So scroll down to Internet Information Services right there. And if you want to install all of the features, including the management tools and FTP server, then you can go ahead and check that. But for this, all we need is the World Wide Web services. So simply check that box and hit OK. There we go. So after about a minute, it downloads the required packages and is completed with installing them. So your next step is simply to go to your C drive, and now you have a new folder here called inetpub. And inside here, we have the directories that are required for the web server. And all you need to do is go into your www root folder here. And as you can see, it already puts in an example site that we can actually simply go into our web browser and take a look at what it is by typing in http://localhost. And as you can see, there is the web server with Internet Information Services default. So if you want to change that to anything that you want, simply just delete these files, create a new file in Notepad, run this as administrator, and this is a test of my new site. And we need to save this into that folder. Inetpub www root and name this as index.html. And now go back to the localhost, and there you can see the text that we just put. This is a test of my new site. So I have an example site here, a Bootstrap example site that I just created. And in order for me to test this out, let me drop it in the web server here. We need administrative permission. So that let's take a look at this example Bootstrap website. And there we go, very simple, small Bootstrap site. And you can change whatever you want on it. So in order for other people to go to this site, if you are new to networking, all you need to know how to do is how to port forward your computer with your router. So, in order to do that, open up a command prompt or PowerShell, and you need to find your local IP address of the machine you're using along with your gateway IP address, which is the IP address for your router. And once you find out the IP address for your router, then you type that into your web browser, go to the port forwarding section on it, and then port forward port 80 to your local IP address. So that command is simply ipconfig. As you can see here, this is my local IP address, and this is the gateway address. So this is the one you type into your web browser, http://, this address. Go to the port forwarding section and then add port 80 to this IP address. After you do that, anybody that types in your external IP address into their web browser will go to your site right here as long as your machine is on. So by finding your external IP address for them to type in after you're done port forwarding, simply type into Google IP address, and it shows you your public IP address right here under the ad. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe if this helped you and share it with a friend. Thanks.